still in that snarksgiving spirit the choice and remember, death is not an option the way Ryan Pace and John Fox have replaced Robbie Gould or the way Ryan Pace and John Fox have replaced Alshon Jeffrey. Let's deal with Jeffrey because his Eagles play hosts to the Bears on Sunday. Gould comes to town next week with the 49ers. It's not just a schedule with the Bears, it's a calendar of embarrassment. So, anyway, Jeffrey has played every game for Doug Pederson's Eagles this season. He missed 9 of 32 games for Fox's Bears. The Bears always seemed to grumble about Jeffrey's soft tissue injuries and his choice to train away from Hollis Hall. Anyone who has looked at Bears injury lists under Fox would understand why a player would train elsewhere. Thing is, it doesn't matter who you blame for the broken relationship, but you have to blame Fox and GM Ryan Pace for failing to replace Jeffrey with a number one receiver. Of course, the Bears will point to injuries to Kevin White and Cam Meredith. White remains a never was, Meredith a 1 year maybe, and besides, every team suffers injuries. Bad teams are unprepared for them. Hello, Bears. Jeffrey has 6 TDs this season, which is 2 more than Bears wide receivers combined, and that's counting Tariq Cohen as a wideout and the one score by Syndicate Deontay Thompson. If you're listing personnel and coaching failures at Hollis Hall, this one pantses them all. Quick, someone tell Pace and Fox that negligence at wide receiver is no way to raise a potential franchise quarterback. Wait, should this Sunday's over cinders for Fox's Bears be 44 points or the 5,411 final win Mark Trestman's Bears played in Philadelphia 4 years ago? One of the more disappointing drives in the Bears' loss to the Lions last Sunday, if you can call 1 yard a drive, came early in the second half. Trailing's 2,117, the Bears started at the 50, and Mitch Trubisky immediately faced third dead long, and then he promptly overthrew Marcus Wheaton. A team that needs points has to get points out of that starting position, rookie quarterback or no. You know who was awake last Sunday? Dowell Logans, that's who. For a while, anyway. The Bears offensive coordinator came out with varied formations, mixed passes and runs, used the shotgun and direct snaps, targeted wideouts, tight ends and backs, and even found Tariq Cohen. It was almost as if Logans heard the Firefox tack and knew that Bears coaching candidate Jim Bob Cooter was calling plays on the other side of the field. And then, once the Bears finished their script, Logans channeled his inner John Shoup. The Pro Football Hall of Fame announced its list of semi-finalists that includes first-time candidates Brian Urlacher, Randy Moss and Ray Lewis. Urlacher should be a gimme, but you never know. The voters might prefer the wide receiver who ran over a traffic cop or the other linebacker who pleaded guilty to obstruction of justice in a double murder. John Lackey reportedly plans to pitch next season, and I'm thinking, wait, didn't Justin Turner retire him last month? The Mets say they have a new plan for their starting pitchers. They won't let them face a lineup the third time through if they're struggling. Oh my, so revolutionary. Who'd have ever thought of that? Other than every other team ever, I mean. Chicago will host the 2020 NBA All-Game, by which time, and you have to love the symmetry, the Bulls could be a 20-win team. Panthers GM Dale Tallon, a former Hawks GM, on Mark Bergevin, GM of the floundering Canadiens and a former Hawks executive, I feel bad for Mark. Most times, they have more media than we have fans. What's up, Darnell Autry? Bears vs. Eagles. Can Bears stop the Eagles' offense and score themselves? Alshon Jeffrey fell into Eagles' lap. Now maybe they ride his Super Bowl prediction. Bears celebrating Mitch Trubisky's small victories in absence of wins.